One of these pieces is called Plus Sonat Clam Ballet. It's sort of difficult to translate, but that doesn't make any difference. It has more or less to do with that there is more to it than more noise than actual forethought or plan. It was sort of a play on words and thoughts because it was written for a friend of mine, Iblanski Otto, who is a horn virtuoso, lives in Sweden, and he came to Iceland for the Arts Festival in 1972, and then the idea was born that maybe it would be nice that I could give him a little piece that he could play with some Icelandic friends here in Reykjavik for the festival. So that was the first piece. The tema senza variazioni, that is also sort of a play on words, that is not exactly play on words, but it's sort of a stretching of a meaning, because when you are growing up studying the piano as a child, there are very many pieces that are called tema con variazioni, easy variations on a theme, classical compositions by the great masters. And I thought, well, how would it be to have a theme, a sort of an endless theme, and without variations, without variations. And so that's how that came to be, theme without variations. It's sort of a continuous expanding piece, I thought, expanding like the universe itself, which is ever expanding, they say. So this piece is not that long that it will ever come to the end of expansion, but that was the idea behind that, and I think that meaning or feeling comes through. The third piece is the shortest. It's called Greeting, or In Memoriam. It's written in memory of my dear friend Gunnar Eilsson, clarinetist. We were associates and we played together quite often, concerts here and there. And he died last autumn, and I thought it was fit and proper to send him a short greeting in notes. It's more or less based on the letters of his name, Gunnar Eilsson. And that's all I can say about that.